How did you begin your interest in music? When did that begin? How did that start?
The moment I was born, I think. It was my childhood very difficult because I had a problem with my health and all these things, terrible things. I remember myself in the hospital and, of course, the school, singing all the time, the prayer every day. I was singing the prayer or the national celebrations. So from the early age, I had the consciousness that my big love is the music, and I had a strong connection with the singing, with the song, with the, from very, very early, I remember myself. So I met, when I was a pupil, I had been discovered by Mikis Theodorakis, and he heard my voice, and I was a pupil in the school, and he told me, do you know that you have a very good voice, and do you want to come my prestessa? And I said, yes, I know. I want, of course, to. And it was something crazy. This so became my mentor, Mikis Theodorakis. It was a very, very strong relation. And since then, I followed his journey, his musical journey, which is very, very interesting, and it has many, many, I would say, very strong, intense, and also nice experiences all over the world. I would say that I was quite lucky enough. It was a stroke of αγαθή τύχη, a stroke of luck,
fortune,
to meet him, and since then I'm I am close to him. Although the last years he cannot travel, he cannot write music, but he, of course, but he's, you know, he's still passionate and alert, I would say. He's involved with the current issues, current affairs in Greece. Every time he wants to be involved by writing or by saying things, and he wants to be no absent, to be
baron.
Yes. Theodorakis is not for me, of course. It's very easy for everyone to understand what does he mean for me. But the thing is, what does he mean for the people, the Greek people, and all over the people in Europe? Theodorakis is our history, our truth, and he has. He has expressed the people and their agony, their about situation and political, but existential, about the artistic things. Mm-hmm. He was very, very, very important personality in Greece.
Very outspoken.
Yes, very and. He's a great musician. Apart all these things, and he's a fighter, he's a great fighter. He's a great musician. He started by writing, composing symphonies, classical work. I know that when he was in exile, the period before I was born. I mean, during the Civil War, it was after the Nazist occupation. It was a very hard situation with the civil war in Greece. So he was in prison, mm-hmm. in exile, and he was composing, writing all the time, music, classical music. Later on, in 1963, he became in Paris and London. Even here in London, he has composed a ballet for in Covent Garden. Mm-hmm. It's been played. Music for films, a lot different kinds of music. And he came back in, I remember, 1963 when he discovered me. Mm-hmm. I was a little girl, and he started to compose songs based on Greek poetry. He wrote music, he composed music for all the biggest poets, the winners, the prize, Nobel Prize winners, mm. the poets, like Yorgos Seferis, Odysseas Elitis, Yanis Ritsos, of course, not Nobel, but other awards he's awarded. And so this that he has succeeded is to bring the poetry, which has very deep feeling and meanings, yeah. the poetry,
yeah.
for, of course, for love, but they have existential messages, philosophical messages,
spiritual,
of course, and to bring to the lips of the people, to sing the people, mm-hmm. the poor people, or the people, uneducated people. It was the first knowledge with the poetry, and some of them, they started to read afterwards, after the songs, because they sing it in tavernas everywhere, oh. songs popular. Oh. It was a movement very, very, very spiritual, as you said, and a very, very important movement, artistic movement. But at the same time, he had messages, of course, social messages. It was not a political speech, no, or sermon, or no. It was real art. You understand?
Yeah.
And
creativity.
Yeah, creativity and universal. It had. You know, the music by Mikis is influenced by classical European music, like German music, Schubert, I would say, Lieder,
yeah.
and also influenced by the Greek traditional music, very old, from antiquity, later the Byzantine music, yeah. Byzantium. And also the folk music, the traditional Greek songs, which is the main thing, the first material that influenced all the artists, all the big artists in Greece. They took the primal pieces from our tradition, so old tradition. Big authors, big actors, big musicians. So Mikis wrote music for theaters, for tragedies, for symphony orchestra, for and songs. He became very known because of his songs, mm-hmm. because and mm-hmm. he was beloved by the people. Mm-hmm. I was lucky and very proud that I lived at the same time with Mikis Theodorakis and also another composer, Manos Hatzidakis, and great poets like Yorgos Seferis. Mm. It was very, very good
energy
in that period. And still, still, although Mikis doesn't function, he's not in the first step, I mean, but his first line, but his he's in life and he gives energy to everybody.